actually want to begin by saying that there is a new policy brief that has recently come out of the ILO, which says that there will be 13 million fewer women in employment in 2021 compared to 2019. And this is a direct result of women having suffered disproportionate job and income losses because of their overrepresentation in the hardest hit sectors because of COVID. And, you know, if capital has taught us anything, it's that they're not going to take care of people, and definitely not the large group of informal workers that are pretty much left to their own devices. When Sister Simel was speaking, I was reminded of a very interesting example, actually, from South Africa, which is called the Digital Platform Cooperative Project. And what their long-term vision is to build a worker-owned digital cooperative platform for domestic and care workers in South Africa. And it's very interesting because it seeks to build a business model that is not concerned just with profits, but it will be like a marketplace for domestic workers as well as those who need the services of domestic and care workers. And I think this process is called disintermediation, which, you know, meaning reduction of a lot of lot of middle persons and intermediaries. So I think, you know, because informal workers are so fragmented, we know that, and especially women home-based workers, even though they live in the same communities, they're not collective as a united working group of women who are performing home-based tasks. So given that nature of work and the vast inequalities that exist, you know, I think collective ownership is actually a very attractive option for a platform that is dedicated to empowerment rather than a business that is just purely concerned with profits, right? So I think home-based workers have, could take a leaf from that book. And, you know, there are obviously going to be challenges. We know that, you know, like who owns what? I mean, we are in the world of big data, whether we like it or not. And even if there's a cooperative digital platform, which is based on the ideals of sustainable and social solidarity economy, you know, how to sustain it and how to make sure that while it grows and does well, that it needs to professionalize and that in that process, it doesn't alienate the workers who started the platform in the first place, you know, because you need more trained people to handle the platform and so on. So those kind of issues will exist. And I really do think, though, that there is a scope for there is an opportunity for home-based workers to think of this kind of a cooperative platform going forward, because I do think there is potential there for these collectively owned and operated platforms to offer a route to fairer and maybe more inclusive outcomes that can generate tangible outcomes for workers who own those cooperatives. Like Sister Simel said, and also Punsap and Brother Edwin, I cannot agree more that a very enabling regulatory framework would be required to nurture these kind of worker-led cooperatives in the digital world going forward. Having said that, I again want to thank you all on behalf of my organization, Learn, and from South Asia for such an enlightening webinar. Thank you so much.